Hey Argos fans, Neely Franceschi here with you again for the Argos Admirals. This week we're going to preview the Argos' upcoming matchup against the BC Lions on Saturday night in Vancouver. Last time these two football teams met, the Lions went into Rogers Centre and defeated the Argonauts 18-9. It was an absolute defensive clinic for the BC Lions. They did a tremendous job against Corey Boyd and Ricky Ray. Boyd, in his final game as an Argonaut, rushed for just 23 yards. Ray throwing three interceptions and just over 200 yards of passing. He had problems working out against the BC Lions secondary of strong secondary. That is indeed of Dante Marsh, Corey Banks, and Byron Parker, a former Argonaut right there that almost took one back to the house, if you recall, in that football game, which it was called back due to a penalty. And that negated what would have been certainly an emphatic way to return to the Rogers Center for Byron Parker. However, this time around, we're looking forward. And the Argonauts are coming off another victory, back-to-back victories, that is now, against their rivals, the Hamilton Tiger Cats. An emphatic win for the Argonauts on Saturday afternoon with Chad Tackert in his fourth start as the Argos running back. He had a tremendous football game, rushing for 172 yards and three touchdowns along the ground, adding 63 yards receiving, providing yet again a solid target for Ricky Ray out of the backfield. He was absolutely tremendous. He is the second most, he's the second man in Toronto Argonauts history to record three rushing touchdowns on the ground, tied for the second most in team history for rushing touchdowns in a single game, and the last person to do it before him was Michael Jenkins back in 2001. So certainly a lot of history made in that football game a week ago against the Ticats. But the big thing is the standing implications that game had. That victory propelled the Argos to now three games ahead of their Eastern Division rivals, the Hamilton Ticats, and also put them into a tie with the Montreal Alouettes for top spot in the Eastern Division. Certainly a huge victory for the Argonauts. This week, however, the defending Grey Cup champs. It's round two. Time for the Argonauts to show that they are for real. As we make our way down the stretch of the CFL season, BC Lions are on a roll, just as they did last year when they started 0-5. They got on a hot streak. However, this year, they're much more respectable. A record of 7-4, the best in the CFL right now. Without a doubt, they are the best team as it stands right now. The Argonauts hoping to make an impact and show that they can be the best in the CFL. The BC Lions defense is studded with star-caliber players up front and in the secondary. They have Adam Big Hill and Solomon Eliminian now after trying out for the NFL. They're a lethal linebacking tandem. Their secondary is nothing to play around with. They have Dante Marsh, Corey Banks, Byron Parker, Lynjay Shell, just to name a few. The secondary is solid. It's going to be a tough night for Ricky Ray, but he's going to have to utilize Chad Tackert quite a bit because that was the story last week, and it worked out well for the Toronto Argonauts. The Argos haven't run heavy with Chad Tackert. They've been very, very balanced, and that's done a good job for Ricky Ray. It's allowed him to throw the ball 30 times a game. However, it's also allowed him to lay back there, use the play-action pass, and open space downfield, and he's utilized the likes of Chad Owens, newcomers, Maurice Mann, and Kenyon Rambo. And we also have another historical mark from the Argonauts' perspective. The Argonauts, back-to-back weeks, recording pick sixes. Pat Watkins last week and Ahmad Carroll on Labor Day. So that's certainly something to keep an eye on. Can we make it three in a row? We'll find out. But that was certainly a big story as well. The defense has been solid of late, especially in this back-to-back sweep of the Ticats. The defense was stellar and was a huge aspect of why the Argonauts were able to come out of this mini home-and-home series with the sweep. The Argonauts, last time they met, certainly those memories are still in their mind. However, they're looking ahead. They're looking at the most important and crucial point of the season. They're looking to make an impact. They're looking to prove everybody wrong and show that they are the best in the Eastern Division. And the BC Lions are no pushover, and we're not taking them as a pushover. But the BC Lions better watch out because the Toronto Argonauts are coming to town. And they have a new running weapon, not like last time. But this time it's Chad Tackert, and it might be his time to shine yet again for the Argonauts. See you on Saturday, Argos fans.